22. It is now time to strengthen and widen its ambit further to include major link routes which connect habitations to agricultural and rural markets, higher secondary schools and hospitals. The Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana Phase 3 will include such linkages. हम वर्षों से ये कहते रहे हैं कि भारत एक कृषि प्रधान देश है जैसे भारत एक कृषि प्रधान देश है वैसे ही देश के जिले में किसी न किसी विशिष्ट कृषि उत्पादन की जाने जा सकते हैं लेकिन हमने इस पर विशेष ध्यान अब तक नहीं दिया जैसे उद्योग जगत में क्लस्टर बेस्ड विकास का मॉडल अपनाया गया है वैसे ही हमारे जिलों में विशेष कृषि उत्पादन पदों चिन्हित पर उन्हें वैज्ञानिक तरीके से क्लस्टर मॉडल पर विकसित करने की आवश्यकता है Cultivation of horticulture crops in clusters brings advantages of scales of operations and can spur establishment of the entire chain of productions to marketing besides giving recognition to the districts for specific crops. The Ministry of Agriculture and Farmer Welfare will reorient the ongoing schemes and promote the cluster-based development of agri-commodities in regions in partnership with ministries of food processing, commerce and other allied ministries. Our government has promoted organic farming in a big way. Organic farming with farmer producer organizations and village producer organizations in large clusters of preferably 1,000 hectares each will be encouraged. Women self-help groups will also be encouraged to take up organic agriculture in clusters under the National Rural Livelihood Program. Our ecology supports cultivation of highly specialized medicinal and aromatic plants. India is also a home to a large number of small and cottage industries which manufacture perfumes, essential oils and other associated products. Our government shall support an organized cultivation of associate industries. I propose to allocate a sum of rupees 200 crores for this purpose. Food processing sector is growing at an average of 8% per annum. The Prime Minister's Krishi Sampada Yojana is our flagship program for boosting the investment in food processing. Allocation in the food processing ministry is being doubled from 715 crore in the RE for 17-18 to 1400 crore in 18-19. The government will promote the establishment of specialized agro-processing and financial institutions in this sector. Tomato, onion and potato are basic vegetables consumed throughout the year. However, seasonal and regional production of these perishable commodities poses a serious challenge in connecting farmers and consumers in a manner that satisfies both my government proposes to launch an Operation Green on the lines of Operation Flood. Operation Green shall promote farmer producers organizations, agri-logistics, processing facilities and professional managements. I propose to allocate a sum of rupees 500 crores for this purpose. India's agri-export potential. India's agri-exports potential is as high as $100 billion against a current support export of rupees of $30 billion. To realize this potential, export of agri-commodities will be liberalized. I also propose to set up a state-of-the-art facility in 42 mega food parks. Yes, sir. I propose to
don't worry.
I propose to extend the facility of Kisan credit cards to fisheries and animal husbandry farmers to help them to meet their working capital needs. इस व्यवस्था से छोटे और सीमांत किसानों को लाभ मिलेगा। Bamboo is green gold. We have removed bamboo grown outside the forest areas from the definition of trees. Now I propose to launch a restructured national bamboo mission with an outlay of rupees 1290 crores to promote bamboo sector in a holistic manner. Many farmers are installing solar water pumps to irrigate their fields. Generation of solar electricity is harvesting by sun by the farmers using their lands. Government will, of India will take necessary measures to encourage the state governments to put in place a mechanism that their surplus solar power is purchased by distribution companies or licensees at reasonably remunerative prices. Our government set up a long-term irrigation fund in NABARD for meeting the funding requirements of irrigation work. Scope of the fund would be expanded to cover specified command area in development areas. Last year, I had announced the setting up of the micro irrigation fund for facilitating expansion of coverage under the micro irrigation and dairy processing infrastructure development fund to help finance investment in dairy farming. It is now time to expand such focused investments. I now announce the setting up of a fishery and aquaculture infrastructure development fund of fisheries sector and an animal husbandry infrastructure fund for financing infrastructure requirement in the animal husbandry sector. The total corpus of these two funds would be rupees 10,000 crores. Our government has already steadily increasingly the volume of institutional credit for agricultural sector on a year to year from 8.5 lakh crores in 2014-15 to 10 lakh crores in 2017-18. I now propose to raise this amount to rupees 11 lakh crores for the year 2018-19. Presently, lessee cultivators are not able to avail crop loans. Consequently, a significant portion of the arable land remains hollow, and tenant cultivators are forced to secure credit from usurious money lenders. Niti Aayog, in consultation with the state governments, will evolve a suitable mechanism to enable the access of lessee cultivators to credit without compromising the rights of the landowners. Government will extend a favorable taxation treatment to farmer producer organizations for helping farmers to aggregate the needs of input farm services, processing and sales operation. I shall give the details of this in part B of my speech. Air pollution in the Delhi NCR region has been a cause of concern. A special scheme will be implemented to support the efforts of the government of Haryana, Punjab, Uttar Pradesh and NCT Delhi to address the air pollution and subsidized machinery required for an in-situ management of the crop residue. Adhyaksh Mahodaya, Desh ki Vartaman Sheesh Netritva, Garibi ko bahut kareeb se dekhkar garibi ke में जीकर यहां तक पहुंचा है. एससी एसटी वर्गों की, पिछड़ों की, आर्थिक रूप से कमजोर वर्गों की चिंताएं होती हैं, उन्हें भलीभांति परिचित हैं. गरीब और मध्यम वर्ग के लिए केस स्टडी नहीं, बल्कि वो खुद ही केस स्टडी हैं. पिछले 3 वर्षों से सरकार की योजनाएं का केंद्र गरीब रहा है, मध्यम वर्ग रहा है. ये सरकार गरीब की छोटी छोटी चिंताओं और बड़ी बड़ी समस्याओं को दूर करने के लिए लगातार कोशिश करती रही है. गरीब महिलाओं की लकड़ी के धुएं से मुक्ति के लिए मिले, इसके लिए प्रधानमंत्री जी ने उज्ज्वला योजना शुरू की थी. शुरुआत में 5 करोड़ गरीब महिलाओं को मुफ्त गैस कनेक्शन का लक्ष्य रखा था, लेकिन इस योजना की गति को देखकर महिलाओं इसकी लोकप्रियता को देखते हुए इसका लक्ष्य बढ़ाने जा रहे हैं. अब सरकार उज्ज्वला योजना के तहत 8 करोड़ गरीब महिलाओं को मुफ्त गैस कनेक्शन देगी.